Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for June the 8th of 2020, well, it is titled Atmospheric Ring of Venus. So what do we see here? Well, this is an image of the planet Venus, and this is when it was at Inferior Conjunction just a few days ago. And that means Inferior Conjunction is when a planet that orbits closer to the Sun than the Earth passes in between the Earth and the Sun. So here we see Venus. We are looking at the dark side of Venus, and the illuminated side pointing away from us towards the Sun, but we also see some light making it through the atmosphere. So because Venus has an atmosphere, light will pass through that atmosphere and be bent, and it still makes it visible as a ring around the planet, even though none of the planet that we're looking at is being directly illuminated by the Sun. And now, why is it not at the Sun or in front of the Sun? And that's because the orbits of the planets are all tilted slightly. While we can approximate the solar system as a very flat plane, as in drawing them on a piece of paper, in reality, all of the planets are slightly tilted. So most of the time, even though Venus is between the Earth and the Sun, it isn't directly between the Earth and the Sun. It's slightly above or slightly below. And in this case, it was about a degree away from the Sun. About a degree would be about two full moons next to each other. So it was reasonably far away from the Sun. Of course, the Sun would still have to be blocked out in order to get this image because it would only occur during the day. Obviously, when Venus is very close to the Sun, you can only see it when the Sun is up. It would not be visible in the evening. And Venus is now transitioning into the morning sky, and very soon you'll be able to see Venus as the morning sky star rising just before sunrise. So looking off to the east before sunrise, you'll be able to see Venus there, and it will get higher and higher in the sky over the coming couple of months. This will also occur at the time when Venus is closest to the Earth, being between the Earth and the Sun. It'll be about as close to the Earth as possible, making it the closest planetary object to us. The only closer object that we regularly see would be our own moon. So it would be at its closest and therefore appear at the largest as well. So Venus appears at its largest here on June the 2nd and will, over the coming months, start to shrink in size. It will be visible as a crescent phase and then will slowly thicken and shrink as it moves further around the Sun and further away from the Earth over the coming months. So that was our picture of the day for June the 8th of 2020. It was titled Atmospheric Ring of Venus. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Orion's Mountains. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.